Hello? Anybody home? Hello? Anybody here?
The situation out here is one of needs that are growing. Unfortunately, some of the things we're seeing are not good. What we're trying to do is to let people in the community know about the needs that are present here. We don't see these on a day-to-day basis. We don't see these when we go to the beach or we go shopping, but there are many people that are hurting here.
Space to do anything. We're on top of each other all the time.
You like to have your own house, right? Nobody's bothered you. And also, I want to have my kids their own room. Like, I have four kids. I want my own kids in one room. So, which is like, I need the house for five rooms. So that's impossible.
The reason why we decided to go camping for the whole summer season and part of the fall, spring, which was the weekends, is because we could not afford to hold on to a year-round rental. We stayed at the campgrounds the whole entire summer up to the first week of September, and we are here now in this winter rental, which is a lot more affordable for us. And if we have to do it again, we'll do it again. Rent during the winter and camp during the summer.
There's a great difference between the life that people who come from the city and have a second home lead and those who live here year-round. And the size of the houses is certainly a physical representation of the fact that there are people who are here just on weekends who have huge houses and people here who have a family per bedroom.
I've been looking for a long time. It's really hard to find housing out here. And as long as I'm having to try to catch up with the rent here, and which I've been behind, and that's why right now I'm in the middle of eviction. But, you know, with me having to try to keep up with the rent, and I don't get any assistance from anywhere, not even food stamps, so I'm buying food, paying for my daycare. Wait a minute. And, you know, it's just, I can't maintain what I have and move. It's just not possible for me right now.
So we need to share. Share the rent, share the electricity, share everything. So that's much better to share instead to live alone and pay too much money for the rent. It's really hard to live alone in this country because everything is expensive, and also we can pay like $1,500 a month, and we can pay electricity like $200 a month.
Our economy has changed. Let's say you can get a house here for the summer season for around $35,000, and that's what makes, you know, kind of made the prices for year-round rentals go up, because outsiders were taking advantage of it, which I don't blame. But at the end, you know, local people and people that really want to stay here and people that work here, those are the ones that get the stick.
Thank you.
problems of people who are needed for local industry, working families, and they are not paid a livable wage in many cases, and yet they're needed to keep our resort industry going, and there's a mix that doesn't match, which is between education levels for people and adequate housing, livable wages, et cetera. There are things that need to be reviewed.
We have the Peconic Housing Initiative to reach out to other people in the community that might want to be involved, and similar to the way a Kay Kidder in West Hampton Beach got involved. And she was very interested in helping the homeless.
In speaking of our sort of two-class society that we have out here, the people with a great deal of wealth and the people who have a great deal of needs and not enough to support their families, I would like to see an increased awareness between the two. And I would like people who may only be here during the summer, but if they're here summer after summer, generation after generation, that they become part of the community and participate in helping us to answer these questions, because they have the wherewithal to do it.
Did you know that there's a homeless population out here?
No, not really, because as I say, I only spend a few months a year out here.
I live here year-round. I am a year-round resident of East Hampton Town.
Did you know that there's a homeless population out here?
No, I did not.
Okay, can you tell me how you feel about hearing that, what I just told you?
It depresses me, because this town has a lot of money, and people in this town have a lot of money, and unfortunately, to hear something like that depresses me.
We see the needs of the people on the East End that are hurting out there, that people don't know about, and we want to make that link, we want to make that connection. So a personal goal of mine is to somehow get that word out about those needs.
We would also have to work too. We would have to collect wood for the fire at night to keep us warm. We would have to keep our tent clean, that way we don't have sand in it and feel uncomfortable when we go to sleep.
My dream for my family, well, I want all my kids grown up and get a good job, good education.
Long term goal that I have is to go back to school. I always want to open up a restaurant because I'm a good cook.
I want to learn computers so that way I can have I want to get my diploma, I can get a good job in the future.
It's like, when I was on the street and then moved into the motel, that was like the best thing to me, because at least we had a roof over our head. And now it's like, okay, I went to the point where I just had a roof over my head. Now I want a home, I want my children to come home and be happy. I want us to be able to cook and, just be comfortable in a house, not us living in one little room.